What is mortgage underwriting, and how does it affect you as a mortgage borrower? We're going to talk all about the underwriting process, so we're getting started right now. Hey, what's going on? I'm Emmett Dempsey, mortgage advisor with Geneva Financial here in beautiful Port Saint Lucie, Florida, and welcome to another mortgage and home buying tip. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more about mortgages or the home buying process in general, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and ring that bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, what is mortgage underwriting? What does that mean for you as a mortgage borrower? You might hear all these terms as we're talking about, you know, it's submitted to underwriting, so you probably got that message. So what does an underwriter do? I liken underwriters, they're kind of like our judges. You know, they're kind of like the Supreme Court of our company. They kind of interpret the laws of mortgages, and they give an approval, and then they make your loan clear to close, and they allow you to close on your mortgage. So, but what they do is they interpret the laws of mortgage that we call guidelines.
Then I expect you to conform to the guidelines I have laid out.
So most of the mortgages that we do, or really any mortgage that is done, has a set of rules. And those rules are called guidelines. Like, what is the minimum credit score? What is the maximum debt to income? What income sources are allowed? You know, there's certain bank statement loans. Even though they're not regular loans, they still have their own set of guidelines. So an underwriter will take what the processor has given them, all of the package, all of the stuff, all of the appraisal, title, income documentation. Like, here's the package for the loan they want to do. And the underwriter takes that information, and then they bounce it off of guidelines. And they go through all of their checks, identifying any kind of red flags that might have been missed. Once everything has been approved according to guidelines, they'll issue what's called a conditional approval or approval of conditions. So, you know, that initial approval is not your final approval, because every underwriting approval always has approval with conditions. I have yet to get a one-touch clear-to-close in my 10-plus year career. So there's always something that an underwriter will find in order to, as minor as it will be. So your first approval will be approval with conditions. So they interpret the guidelines, what's necessary for income, assets, et cetera, based on the loan scenario that we presented. And a lot of times I tell my borrowers, I'm kind of like your advocate or almost your attorney. I'm not a licensed attorney, just as a disclosure. But basically, I make the case for you to underwriting. I was like, here's my borrower who wants to borrow X thousands of dollars to buy this house. Here's all their information. Here's how much money they make. Here's how much money they have, et cetera. And it's kind of like making a case. Then the underwriter and the processor who streamlines your information gives it to the underwriter. And they say, well, you know, yes, basically we'll give it a loan based on these guidelines. They meet all the guidelines. You know, so they check against things like foreclosure wait times, make sure it's 3 years for FHA or 7 years for Fannie Mae. So they check all these different things to make sure it complies with the guidelines of any loan product you're doing. So to answer the question, what is mortgage underwriting? That's what they are. They're basically the judges who interpret your information against guidelines. So hope that's informative about what mortgage underwriters do for you. And the best words you'll ever hear on your loan are clear to close, because that means you're going to the table, or you're buying your house, or you're getting your cash, or you're doing your refinance. So if you want to learn more about mortgages or the home buying process in general, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and ring that bell so you don't miss anything. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.